frequencies open. Right, I'm going to try something new for this channel. No, it's not opening one of these. Although I am going to be opening one of these. Because I'm going to need this at least. It's not important, well, it is important for the music, so yes. I'm going to clean my hands off. Hopefully this doesn't take up all the time of the thingamajig, but if I run over, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, hit the bell, leave a comment, and join me on my journey to 100. I'll be very, 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 very grateful if you do. That's in the bin. It's out of the way. Right, time for a new feature. Live review. Because it will be like, even though I won't be going out live, it'll be live. Because I'll be doing it live here, first time I'm reading it. And the first subject is Seven Secrets, issue number one, from Tom Taylor, Danielle Di Nicolo and Walter Biamonte. So this is a live read and review. Now you know why I didn't do my hand. Initially, the cover's nice, little 7-inch box, Tom Taylor, Walter Biamonte, with colours assisted by Katia Rinaldi, led by Ed Dukeshire as well, created by Tom Taylor and Danielle Di Nicolo. Yeah. So, all these lovely people. Ooh, Chris Paddy's logo design, nice. A little bit anarchy, kind of. But yeah, anyway, I waffle now. I have a secret. Box with a one on. Interesting. I'm guessing there was the 7 cases and 6 of the cases are gone or captured by somebody. Just spitballing. I love that bike chase. That is well drawn, well coloured, well lettered. Yes. Flashback, okay. he said he was allowed to be born. So it's that's a plus. Yeah. Well, that was interesting. Well, obviously well writ. Because you don't feel emotion if it's shit. You know what I mean? You don't feel emotion if it's shit. I thought I was going to kill the babies, so that one got me a little bit. Yeah. But at least I didn't, so that's good. So, and obviously the story's about Casper. I don't think he's a friendly fucking ghost. Oh, I think people are going to die painfully for what they did. It was a fine start. Can't really judge much from the first issue of something that's not connected to anything, but you get this. You get the gist of it tells you all you need to know for now, and hooks you enough that you wanted to get the second issue, which I want.
Get it now.
No, but I liked it very much. We know the real well. We know at least one of the bad guys. We don't know the hidden bad guy, unless it's one of those, or the order guy. But I'll definitely be getting the next one. Boom Module doing really well with these titles. Marvel and DC would be wise to look at their laurels. And no, I don't mean I don't mean Black Canary. And so yeah, artwork was fine. Yeah, I love the splash page with the but with the. Where was it? That was, I think, my favourite art page of art of the thingamajig. All the art was pretty damn good, obviously, as I said. But that bike chase thing, that was my favourite. So yeah, if you haven't had, go out and order a copy. If there's any left in shop, go grab a copy. I got mine from OK Comics, in the heart of Leeds, cracking shop. Lovely stuff. Hi, Jared and Danielle. nothing more to say, really. I've done the review, live review. Yes. Now to wait for next issue. Don't know if I'll do one of these again. I'm a little bit self-conscious, because even though I don't edit, so I always worried about whatever how I look, you know, doing these, but it's done, so don't forget to like, share, subscribe. I already did all this crap at the beginning of the story. So I'll talk to you all later. Peace, and I'm out of here. Frequencies off.